Hi, I'm Dan Weiser from PLR Planners, and in this video I'm going to show you how to use our Photoshop strip maker, which enables you to create unique borders for either your book covers or for your pages, or you can sell them as individual items on your Etsy store or on your own website. So I've opened one of the strips that I've got, and if you have a look over here, I've got a set of papers that I'm going to be using. So there's a set of papers that I'm going to be using, and I'll show you how that works. So there's two things that you can do. You can either change the individual layer over here. So if I turn this layer on and off, there's that one over there. This one over here is that layer over there. So in Photoshop, you can manipulate the strips to create unique strips just by turning on the layers on and off. So that's the first step. The second step is that you can actually change the color. So if I select this one over here, which is this bottom arrow, and if I go control click, it gives it marching ants. So let me quickly show you what that looks like. There you can see the marching ants. Now I can go and change the color by clicking on my color bar over there. And I'll select a red. And then go Alt Backspace. And then Control D to get rid of the marching ants. So that's one way you can do it, but the easiest way to do it is simply to use some papers. So let's take this layer over here, for instance. That's that one over there. So I'm going to select the layer, and I'm going to drag a piece of paper over it, just bubbling it across. And then just expand that so that it fits across the whole page. Then I'm going to accept it. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to say create clipping mask. And there you can see it's now put that piece of paper over there. But let's choose another one that's not quite so busy. So let's delete that layer. And I'll bring in this one. Expand it to fit. Right click on the layer, create clipping mask. There we go, that looks a bit better. Okay, so let's take this next layer over here and let's see if we can find something that'll go with that. So let's go for something that's not too busy. So we'll bring in that yellow. Okay, I'm going to expand it. Accept it and then create a clipping mask. Okay, so now we'll just keep on doing that. So let's take that layer over there and let's do this one. Now you can do this with any paper pack that you've got, and you can create multiple different kinds of strips. So we'll create a clipping mask. There we go. I think I'm going to take that bow away, so we'll take that away. Let's go to that. Let's make that bold, so we'll bring that in there. Just drag it down. Accept it. Create a clipping mask. There we go. I like quite like that. And the nice thing is that you can move that paper around until you're happy with the position. Okay, so we'll leave that there. But let's do this one. Let's pick that piece of paper. And let's create a clipping mask. There we go. And then the final one. What should we do with that? Let's do this one here. Accept it and create a clipping mask. Okay. Now, once that's been done, you are ready to save this file. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to File, and you're going to go to Save As, and you're going to select a place to put it. But what you need to do is you need to change the file format to a PNG. Okay, so we'll call it Strips1.png and save it. Now if I open it, there's your strip file that you can use and then sell individually. I can take that strip file and update a book cover with it, or I can sell it individually. Okay, I hope that's helped. If you've got any questions, please feel free to ask. Also, don't forget to join our Facebook group. And if you enjoyed this video or found value, please like it. Thank you.